Hello everyone, welcome to PiSquare Academy. This is Snehalika and today we'll have a discussion on the common symbols of resistors, inductors and capacitors. We'll also have an insight into what is the difference between a choke and an inductor. We'll also have an understanding of choke. Along with that, we'll also have an understanding of dielectrics and insulators. So stay tuned till the end of the video. If you are new to our channel, please like and subscribe us. And for such videos, please hit the bell icon. So let's get started. So the first topic that we'll be taking up is the most lovable resistor. The common symbols are, this is the common symbol of a resistor. Then this is a symbol of a variable resistor. Whenever you have an arrow on the resistor, that indicates the variable resistor. The third one is a preset. What is a preset? It is also a kind of variable resistor. The only advantage with a preset is that presets helps you to calibrate your sensors. Now, what do I mean by calibration of sensors? Whenever you're coming across electronic circuits which are having sensors like light sensors, temperature sensors, voltage sensors or current sensors, then these presets can help you take care of the null point of these sensors. I'll repeat, these presets can help you take care on fixing or calibrating the null point of these sensors. So that is a unique advantage of presets. So once you are into these applications, you can comment and you can know more on this preset. The next category of resistors is a different category actually. These resistors are known as dependent resistors. The first one, varistor, depending on voltage. The second one, thermistor, depending on temperature. And the third one, light dependent resistors, depending on light. These light dependent resistors are also known as LDRs. So a quick recap, these are the dependent resistors depending on voltage, temperature and light, and these are the independent resistors. So that was all about resistors. Now let's move on to inductors. So when I'm speaking of an inductor, I have two categories of inductor as well. A category of air core and a category of non-air core, or a category of a core of non-magnetic material and a category of core of magnetic material. So these two lines are actually indicating that the core is a magnetic material, and if there is no line, this is indicating that the core is of a non-magnetic material. So let me tell that, show it to you. So this is a core. This can be described as an air core, or this is also an air core because the pen that I have used is a non-magnetic material. So I think you got my point that a coil with air or with a non-magnetic material is the category of air core. Now speaking of iron core and ferrite core, I told you that both of them fall into the category of magnetic core. So one being iron, the second being ferrite. So the first one, iron and ferrite, will be having magnetic conductivity, both of them, right? Because they are magnetic materials. Next, the major difference between an iron core and a ferrite core is that iron core allows electrical conductivity. I'll repeat that. Iron core allows electrical conductivity and ferrite core doesn't allow electrical conductivity. And ferrite core doesn't allow electrical conductivity, and hence you can see that there is continuous parallel lines here and there are discontinuous parallel lines here. That is remarkably telling you the difference between the electrical conductivity and the non-electrical conductivity. So iron core will indicate always that any material that I'll be taking which has electrical conductivity as well as magnetic conductivity will fall in the category of iron core. And any core that I pick up which has only magnetic conductivity and no electrical conductivity will be a ferrite core. So I'll show you, this is how a ferrite core looks, if you can see. Okay, so any coil wound on this ferrite core will fall into the category of ferrite core inductors. So lastly, ferrite cores. So ferrite cores having this electrical discontinuity can give a very good advantage of lowering the value of eddy currents. I'll repeat. Since there is no electrical conductivity in the ferrite core, the eddy current losses are very less for a ferrite core, and hence ferrite cores do not need laminations. Because why do we do laminations? We do laminations to reduce these eddy current losses, right? So you need not use a lamination for a ferrite core. So ferrite cores do find their applications for high frequencies. That is one of the major reasons, because at high frequencies your eddy current losses will be reduced. Okay. So that was all about air, iron and ferrite core. I hope you got the differences very clearly. So next we'll move on to the common question that arises is, what is the difference between a choke and an inductor? So what is choke actually? A choke is an inductor with high quality factor. I'll repeat that for you. A choke is an inductor with high quality factor. Now what do you mean by quality factor? Quality factor is given as XL upon R, which indicates that a higher value of inductive reactance and a lower value of resistance, that will give you a high quality factor. So these high quality factor inductors, also known as choke, these high quality factor inductors do find applications in filtering purposes and fluorescent tube as well. Okay, so to understand how these high quality factor inductors are finding application for a fluorescent tube, we do have a video, a practical video rather, on the working of a fluorescent tube with the choke. So please, the link is provided in the description box. Please go and have a look. You will have a better understanding on the difference. So that was all about choke and inductor, that a choke is a high quality factor inductor. Okay. So the last topic of today's sessions is capacitors. So now coming to capacitors, what are capacitors? Two metal plates, I'll show you. Basically, two metal plates separated with a dielectric. Now what is a dielectric? A dielectric is nothing but an insulator. We all know that, right? A dielectric is an insulator. Now how do you distinguish a dielectric from an insulator? A dielectric is an insulator that has the tendency to be polarized in the presence of electric field. I'll repeat that. A dielectric is an insulator who has the tendency to be polarized in the presence of an electric field. So now based on this dielectric, its thickness, its dielectric strength and the electrical permittivity at which it operates, we have different classifications of capacitor. So to cut short and put them into broad categories, we have polarized and non-polarized capacitors. I'll repeat that. Polarized and non-polarized capacitor. The polarized capacitor has a bent plate and a non-polarized capacitor has two straight metal plates. Now why it is bent? Because it has to indicate you that the terminal of the polarized capacitor. It means a polarized capacitor will always indicate or signify a positive and a negative terminal so that you do not blast your circuits. Actually, if you connect the polarized capacitor in the wrong format, you are probably to see a blast in your circuit. So please be careful with that. Always look into the capacitor's polarity for a polarized one. Connect the plus to the plus and the minus to the minus. Now coming to the non-polarized capacitor, they are AC capacitors. The polarity does not matter. The plus and the minus do not matter. So the capacitors that do fall in the non-polarized category are ceramic capacitors and thin film capacitors. For polarized capacitors, we have the famous electrolytic capacitors that fall into this category, as well as supercapacitors. We'll be doing a video shortly on supercapacitors to give you more insight on what are supercapacitors. Okay, so that was all for this video. We learned about resistors, inductors and capacitors. So the takeaway points from the video would be, the first thing, the concept of dependent resistors. The second point would be, no line, air core or non-magnetic material. Lines means magnetic material. Continuous lines indicates electrical conductivity. Discontinuous lines indicate no electrical conductivity. Yeah, you got it right. No electrical conductivity. So that was in short. Then we learnt about choke and inductor. Choke again is an inductor which has a high quality factor. Then we moved on to the capacitors, polarized and non-polarized, the difference between dielectric and insulator. So that was all about the video we learnt. And so tell me, which one did you like the most? Which element or which symbol fascinated you the most? Please put that in the comment box. So that's it. This was about the video. So if you like, please hit the like button, subscribe to us, and do hit the bell icon to get such more videos. So till then, keep rocking, keep learning. Thank you.